Hi, hello once again. It's time for your Turning Point Devo for your happy Friday, August the 27th, 2021, and episode 24. Stop and think. You gotta remember, it's three back. You gotta go three back on the number. So it's gonna go down. It's gonna go down after this weekend when we finish up the thing. So, and I'm gonna try to get all of them, all the devotions for the end of the month. That way, start fresh on the next one. Start with a new book. And probably gonna do that same with the other one too. So I'm gonna finish out all the rest of the month, because I've got the new book of this one, but I don't have the new book of the other one yet. So I have to, it probably have to get sometime this weekend, either sometime today or tomorrow in IRL, get to the post office to pick it up. So I get these here. I got these here, so, but the other ones come to the post office box. But how's everybody doing out there? I hope you enjoyed that. Today we're gonna, for your turning point, we're gonna go on with some more study. About the same study we had in the days of praise, where that one was called Always, which, if you'll look, that says always. And look at the verse. Matthew 28:20. And this one is called Always With You. And the same verse, if you can see it. If you can see that verse. Stop and pause it and look at it. But it's 28:20. It's a little bit different than that one. Well, that one said, it's the same. It's a little bit different. Days of Praise said, I am with you always, even until the end of the world. This one says, I am with you always, even to the end of age. Of the age. So this is a different passage than that one. From a different outlook. Must be from a different standpoint. That says end of the world. This one says end of the age. It's the only difference. But before we go any further, your week, we're going to be reading from Ecclesiastes chapter 4, verses 9 through 12. So get your Bibles and turn it to there. And your daily reading is Ezekiel chapter 13, 14, and 15. So before we do that, smash that like button. Comment what you liked about it. Subscribe if you're new. Comment what you liked about it. Subscribe if you're new and share the video with your family and friends, which will help me out a lot. I would appreciate it if I get some more subscribers from doing that. So, but always with you, and know I am with you always and even until the end of the age. Matthew 28:20. So that's a different version than the one we read in the Days of Praise this morning. Because that one says end of the world, this one says end of the age. That's the only difference. But Ecclesiastes chapter 4, verses 9 through 12, if you're not there yet, turn to it. I'll give you just a second to get to it. If you're not there yet, I'm going to go ahead and start just four short verses. And in my Bible, it is captioned, The Value of a Friend. Two are better than one, because they have a good reward for their labor. For if they fail, one will lift up his companion, but woe to him who is alone when he falls, for he has no one to help him up. Again, if two lie down together, they will keep warm, but how can one be warm alone? Though one may be overpowered by another, two can withstand him, and a threefold cord is not quickly broken. Okay. I'm just for the next for the weekend edition. I'm going to just get it opened up where I can see to it. Okay. Always With You, which I just read that first one. It says it started in 1989 with a TV commercial from a medical alert company and sold a pendant that could contact emergency responders. An elderly woman was seen speaking into her pendant. "I've fallen and I can't get up." That line made its way into cultural conversation, t-shirts, television sitcoms, and music throughout the 1990s. So as much of the phrase was parodied, it nonetheless conveyed a serious message. There's a risk to living a solitary life. And Solomon wrote that when someone falls, his friend can help him up. But woe to him who is alone when he falls. Ecclesiastes 4:10, which that's a different version to the one I read. It is a reminder of the power and value of living in community with others, even if just one other. And living a solitary life is not God's design for humanity. Thankfully, even if we find ourselves alone, we'll know that Jesus is always with us. So being alone, you're never alone with Jesus. He told his disciples, "I am with you always, even until the end of the age," or the world, as in that verse. Matthew 28:20. So marriage, friendships, relationships, groups, congregations, are all thy delays to live amongst friends. But start with Jesus, because he is committed to be with you always. And that's like what we said in the other one. Always. And this was talking about being with somebody always. That one was just being always do this, always do that. That's the difference in the two today. This was just looking at a solitary standpoint. If you're living alone, you're not alone. Jesus is there with you. If you have Jesus in your life. Just remember that, people. Today's turning point is from Augustine. There is no better proof of friendship than to help our friends with their burdens. Amen. That's a good one. Okay. That's all I have for that. Coming up tomorrow in your Days of Praise, one and only video, episode 460, for Saturday, August 28, 2021, we're going to be back in the Duh miniseries, Saturday and Sunday. So tomorrow will be video 22 of the series. We're going to be talking about the apple of the eye, beginning with Zechariah 2, verse 8. And then, like I said, Sunday will be video number 23 with the weight of the wind for Sunday, August the 29th, in episode 461. And that one will be beginning with Job 28, 24, and 25. So that's what's coming up the next two for the Days of Praise. Now your preview for your Sunday video for your next turning point, we're going to be in video or weekend number 5 of 5 with the last part of the Forget Me Not weekend series for August the 28th and 29th. We're going to be in the face of need. So when we started the month out, we had in the face of the unknown. The next weekend, we were in the face of responsibilities. The next weekend, we were in the face of abundance. Last weekend, we were in the face of fear. And then in this one, we're going to be in the face of need. So stay tuned for that. I'll get to those in just a few minutes. You'll see that one on Sunday. Your next turning point will be on Sunday. So. And with that said, I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for more videos just like this coming up in the next few days. But until then, keep on keeping on and trust in God and he'll keep you safe. And all you say and do. And until tomorrow, peace out, everybody. goodbye. God bless. Have a wonderful rest of your happy Friday. And come back again tomorrow for your one and only Days of Praise Devo on your jubilant, for another jubilant Saturday. And then Lord's Day Sunday, double feature on Sunday. That'll be the next one for your turning point. So stay tuned for those. You'll see those in just a few minutes. And I have to go so I can open the door up. So thanks for watching. I'll see you then. Goodbye.